scientists got very interested in, and it's called having a theory of mind. And the best way to describe it is to describe a classic experiment with human children. So imagine you're sitting around and you're telling stories with your younger sister. And you tell them a story, say, well, here's Sally. And Sally has a bowl that she really likes, and she's going to put it in the basket, which is right there in front of her. And she hides the ball in the basket. And here's Anne, Sally's friend, and they're playing together. And Sally then says, I've got to go to the bathroom, so I'm going to leave the room. And when she leaves the room, Anne takes the ball out of the basket and puts it in a box, a green box that she's got next to her. Now Sally comes back into the room and she wants to play with the ball. And supposing you ask your sister, where is Sally going to look for the ball? If your sister is 3 years old, she'll say, in the box, because she knows that's where the ball is. And a three-year-old has knowledge, of course, but can't imagine that other people have knowledge that's different from her own.
Thank you.